Okay, in the last video, we introduced this rather strange substitution. We started off by saying if we have an integral in this general form of the sine of x plus the cosine of x plus a constant, a good way to go about solving it is to use this substitution here, where we call z is equal to the tangent of x over 2. And then we proceeded along those lines, and we expressed the cosine of x in terms of that new variable, and we found an expression for the sine of x in terms of the new variable z, and we found an expression for dx in terms of the variable z. And now I want to kind of demonstrate in this video and some of the others that follow how this technique works in practice. So, let's say we had the integral of dx over 1 plus the sine of x. And as you can see, this is a simple looking integral, but there's no way we have it integrating that right now with our current arsenal of techniques. So we proceed along and we say, all right, z is going to equal the tangent of x over 2. So the sine of x is going to become this, and dx is going to become this. So let's look at the denominator. We've got 1 plus the sine of x. So we have 2z divided by 1 plus z squared, and we want to add 1 to that, so we'll have plus, say, 1 plus z squared divided by 1 plus z squared, and that will equal z squared plus 2z plus 1 divided by 1 plus z squared. And looks like this is z plus 1 squared, so we have z plus 1 quantity squared divided by 1 plus z squared. So the denominator of our integral is this. So when we write the integral, this will equal, since this is in the denominator, we multiply by the reciprocal, 1 plus z squared divided by z plus 1 squared. That's this, and dx is this. That's 2 times dz divided by 1 plus z squared. Those conveniently cancel out. And it looks like it will equal this integral. Z plus 1 to the minus 2 times dz. And this is a cinch. If I said z plus 1, let's call that u, dz would be du. So I have the integral of u to the minus 2 du. So this would be equal to 2. This is now raised to the minus 2 plus 1 power. So we have z plus 1 to the minus 1 divided by that, or that will make this minus 2. And that plus an arbitrary constant would be the solution to this simple integral right here. Okay, but this is supposed to be the solution this one, which we can make it as soon as we put our substitution for z in. So this would be equal to minus 2 divided by, because of the minus 1 here, looks like it would be the tangent of x over 2 plus 1 plus an arbitrary constant. So just to be sure, we claim that this integral here, which before we would have no way of solving, that's equal to minus 2 divided by tangent of x over 2 plus 1 plus an arbitrary constant. And it would be no more than that then. Well, let's see, you've got some time left. If this is the correct answer, if we take the differential of this side of the equation, it should give us what we have inside of the integral sign here. So let's try that out and see if we can verify our answer. We're going to take the differential of minus 2 times tangent of x over 2 plus 1 to the minus 1 power. The differential of that is 0. Okay, so let's see. This would be equal to minus 2. And then for this, we take the minus 1 down. That'll make this a plus 2 times tangent of x over 2 plus 1 to the minus 2 times the derivative of what's inside, and that will be the secant squared. Of x over 2 times the differential of this, which would be 1/2 dx. So it looks like so far we have this. This is just 1 secant squared of x over 2 dx divided by, this is in the denominator, so this would be this squared, so let's multiply it out. We'll have the tangent squared of x over 2 plus 2 times the tangent of x over 2 plus 1. We take this down in the denominator, that will become a plus 2 power. So multiply this out, tangent squared of x over 2 plus 2 times the tangent of x over 2 plus 1. And that looks like the secant squared of x over 2. So this will equal secant squared of x over 2 dx divided by the secant squared of x over 2 plus 2 times the tangent of x over 2. Let's divide everything by the secant squared of x over 2. So this will equal dx, dividing everything out by the secant squared of x over 2. This will give us, in the numerator we have dx, and down here we have 1 plus 2 times the tangent of x over 2 divided by the secant squared of x over 2, or that would be the same thing as multiplying by the cosine squared of x over 2. Okay, let's see, what would this give us now? So here, this will be dx 1 plus 2. This is the sine of x over 2. Write this a little bit neater, divided by the cosine of x over 2 times the cosine squared of x over 2. So this and this are going to cancel, and we have dx divided by 1 plus 2 times the sine of x over 2 times the cosine of x over 2, and hopefully this reminds you of the identity. This right here is the sine of x. So this equals dx over 1 plus the sine of x, and that is what we had here, proving that yes, this is the correct answer to that. And as you can see, getting to this answer is quite straightforward once we use the substitution to get to that step. Okay, that's it for this video. Come back for a couple more videos and we'll get some more practice using the substitution technique.